Rhinoplasty, the quintessential nose job, was said to be a procedure that is not too difficult to carry out but extremely challenging for consistent outstanding results. Aesthetic rhinoplasty is a complex procedure that aims to modify the structure of the nose to improve its static and dynamic appearance. While some other operations may claim difficult anatomic access, requisition of excessive physical strength, or significant operating time causing surgeon fatigue, the operation of rhinoplasty demands a thorough understanding of an art and science. Rhinoplasty stems from the Greek term rhes, nose, and plasion, to shape. It may be defined as any operative procedure that corrects and reconstructs the form, restores the function, and aesthetically enhances the nose. Rhinoplasty is considered the most complex and challenging cosmetic procedure in aesthetic surgery today. Still, it remains an extremely popular surgery, the fourth most common procedure in women and the second most common procedure in men. Its popularity has increased over the years, although not nearly as rapidly as newer procedures such as liposuction. Rhinoplasty seeks to cure psychological depression by restoring a normal shape to the nose. Its social importance is beyond question, and it represents a significant branch of surgical psychotherapy. Rhinoplasty changed considerably in the last decades from a standardized reduction procedure to a highly differentiated problem-oriented procedure with reductions, relocation, and augmentation of tissues are frequently combined. The endonasal, closed, and external, open, techniques are the two main techniques used in both primary and secondary rhinoplasty. With both approaches, the goals are to preserve or achieve normal airflow while delivering an aesthetically pleasing and natural permanent long-term result. Primary rhinoplasty refers to an operation in a previously unoperated nose. The term secondary should be reserved for patients who had at least one prior rhinoplasty by another surgeon. The term revision rhinoplasty is frequently used interchangeably with secondary, even though revision most accurately describes a secondary operation performed by the same, not different, surgeon who performed the previous operation. Creating proportion and balance out of raw nasal tissue, cartilage, and bone requires three-dimensional artistic and surgical skills, advanced training, experience, and a thorough grounding in nasal anatomy, and more than 240 anatomical variables that ultimately determine the shape and function of the nose. Primary rhinoplasty is the most difficult of aesthetic operations for these reasons. 1. Nasal anatomy is highly variable, thereby precluding a one-operation-fits-all approach. 2. The procedure must correct both form and function, and 3. The final highly visible result must meet the patient's high expectations. History. John Orlando Roe entered history as the father of aesthetic rhinoplasty. The age of corrective aesthetic rhinoplasty was inaugurated by John Orlando Roe, 1848-1915, an otorhinolaryngologist from Rochester, New York. This surgeon corrected saddle nose deformities through an endonasal approach. In 1891, Roe also used intranasal approaches for dorsal hump removal. Innovations in the functional aspects of rhinoplasty were later introduced by Mink, Van de Schoek, Cottle, and others. Modern rhinoplasty started in the early part of the 20th century with the pioneering work of Jacob Lewin, Jacques, Joseph, 1865-1934, a German surgeon who not only laid the foundations of reconstructive surgery, but who also had deep insight into the psychological needs of his patients. The approach used by founding fathers of rhinoplasty has often, and incorrectly, been called closed rhinoplasty. The term closed is profoundly misguided, as it implies a blind approach to nasal structures, and should be laid to rest with many other misnomers in current practice. Endonasal rhinoplasty is a much more sensible term, as it describes the surgical approach more accurately and is not weighed down by implications of unseen structures and guesswork in the dark. In 1898, Joseph performed the first reduction rhinoplasty using an external approach. He also did pioneering work in several other areas, including the treatment of both morphological and functional abnormalities in one sitting, the use of intranasal approaches, and the establishment of aesthetic surgery as a medical specialty. In 1904, Joseph reported on the first operation in which the intranasal removal of a dorsal hump was combined with correction of the anterior septum. At that time, intranasal operative techniques were considered unsurgical procedures that were handicapped by poor exposure and a high infection risk. In the 1960s, Cottle introduced cartilage-sparing techniques. This led to a rethinking of rhinoplasty from reduction to conservation of the septum. Despite its problems, the process of reducing the nose continued until the 1970s and formed a backdrop for the next big leap forward. In early 1970, Ivo F. Padovan, a surgeon from Zagreb, presented his external approach rhinoplasty at the first meeting of the American Academy of Facial Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery. Since its advent, external approach rhinoplasty has been the workhorse in the hands of some of the best rhinoplasty surgeons and formed the foundation of rhinoplasty teaching in the most renowned academic centers of excellence worldwide. Unfortunately, no school of rhinoplasty is absolutely perfect for every scenario, otherwise, all surgeons would adopt a single approach and set of techniques. Anatomy. Creation of a harmonious relationship between the face and nose requires consideration of ethnicity and gender identity. Nasal anatomy, while constant in terms of components, varies widely in proportion, thickness, size, and resilience. Success in rhinoplasty begins with a solid three-dimensional understanding of the nasal anatomy and experienced awareness of the functional aspects of the nose. An aesthetically pleasing result of rhinoplasty depends on thorough knowledge of nasal anatomy. Even with open rhinoplasty, it can be challenging to control the precise relationship of the nasal structures. For easier description, anatomy will be discussed as surface anatomy, surgical anatomy, functional anatomy, aesthetic anatomy. Surface anatomy. What is the perfect nose shape? Some patients bring a picture of celebrities such as Brad Pitt or Tom Cruise and demand the same nose for themselves. The general idea is that as these celebrities are accepted as the most beautiful people around, they must have the perfect nose. From a plastic surgeon's perspective, there is no perfect nose, but there is an ideal nose that varies from person to person. As there are different nose types, so there is no one perfect nose form that can make every face balanced and harmonious. The ideal nose shape changes in time. There are so many factors that will determine your ideal nose shape, such as gender, age, ethnicity, skin type, and the shape of the face. So, an experienced and trained eye of plastic surgeon can consider all the factors and come up with the ideal nose for the best balance and harmony on the face. the golden ratio face and nose. The ideal nose has some characteristics that are accepted universally. The most crucial one is symmetry. Golden ratio, a concept formed during the Renaissance, gives the best ratio that the human eye perceives. The universal beauty standard is also based on the golden ratio. While it is a mathematical formula, it is used in every design from architecture to plastic surgery.